Today we're with the Photo Arts Club here in Leisure World, and we had a contest today, and the contest resulted in the first prize, second prize, and third prize winners. And so we're going to get a little bit of explanation from each of the contestants who won the prizes as to their explanation of the photograph. So we're going to start with Roger. And Roger, if you could speak to us over here, can you tell us about your photograph?
Yes, this is my neighbor, Hank Walker. He was the former Commodore of the Seal Beach Yacht Club. Okay, very proud man. Okay, he's a little under the weather right now, and I took this picture a few months ago when he was feeling better, and I was very, very happy and excited to take his picture, okay, in his element, okay?
Okay, Roger, can you give us your full name so we can give you the credit?
Roger Bennett.
And Bennett, how do you spell that?
B-E-N-N-E-T-T in Mutual 7 in Leisure World.
Okay, and who was number two on the, okay? And could you give us your name, please?
Hey, my name is Ben Benjamins, and I joined the photo club about a year and a half ago, and one of the things that kind of struck me was that there was not a whole lot of talk about photography. So I spoke with Regine and I asked her, hey, why don't we do more about specifically photography? And so she said, well, what are we going to do? So anyway, long story, we decided to do different programs every month on a different subject. So just recently, about 3 months ago, I thought, you know what, we're doing portrait photography. Why don't we have a contest? Because typically people, when they work in a contest, they bring their best work forward. And we can see that today, that happened today. We saw some excellent photographs. I got second prize with this black and white photo, which was originally taken in color, but I knew before I even made the photo, I wanted a black and white photo. And the key point of this photograph is that it's black and white. It goes, if you look from the right to the left, you can see it's black, and there's white part of his face. The camera is black, and then again, on the edge, there is white, some semblance of white. He is holding my camera, so to make this photograph, I had to use my iPhone. iPhones have tremendous capability in making photographs. Just because you don't have a $2,000 camera or a $1,000 camera or even a $300 camera, if you have an iPhone, you can make gorgeous, gorgeous photographs. So I think this is the result of one. Again, it's available light, shot close to a window, and I saw what I wanted when I snapped the trigger on the iPhone, and here's the result.
Okay. And then for the third prize winner was Regina.
Regina Schumacher. And I've been the president of the Photo Arts Club for a while now, and I'm so delighted that we have Ben to teach us so many wonderful things about photography, because it's very difficult to come up with a program every month, but he's been a real inspiration, and it's been fun to do the work on portraits. And the one that I took here is of one of the ladies at the guitar club here in Leisure World that meet every Friday afternoon. And they're really great. They have like a jam session. And Ben had suggested when we do a portrait that maybe we would show something that people do, or what they're working on, or whatever. So I thought, well, it might be nice if I ask her and showed that she's playing her guitar. And so she I took it right upstairs near the gym. And I'm very, very pleased that we have such a capable and teacher now who's taught us so much, and we have an enormous amount of suggestions as to future programs also.
Any questions from the audience?
I've been attending the class, the photo and art class, and it's really terrific, really. And I thank you all for being, you know, so interesting. Thank you, teacher. Thank you, Regina.
Well, maybe if each of you guys could tell us a little bit about how long you've been doing photography and how much you personally think you've grown. Let's begin on this side again with Roger.
Okay. I was interested in photography my whole life. I went to photo school in Rochester at Rochester Institute of Technology and got a degree in photo science and art. And I had a camera shop in Downey, California for 40 years. Okay, so I've seen the industry come from box cameras to Instamatic type things to Hasselblads to Nikons, and then over to digital type thing, and photography then as an art form took a whole new level. Okay, so you gotta just, you can take the elements from the old school photography and apply them to digital, but it's just a whole nother system, okay? And I love taking pictures. I take pictures now of my family. I've done the professional type stuff. I've shot weddings, I've shot magazines and sports and stuff like that. But I just take pictures of the kids now and family outings and around pictures around Leisure World. And I really enjoy the club. I found the club just last year, and it's taken over. It's been a wonderful experience in my life. Thank you.
So back when I was in fifth grade, my dad had a one of those old bellows fold-out cameras with the film, the white film with the paper backing, and he showed me how to use it. So I went to a soccer game and I was going to make some prize-winning photographs. What I didn't realize is that you have to be pretty close to the goalie to get a full shot of the goalie catching the ball, where my photo was from the 50-yard line or the 50-meter line, and I could barely see the goalie. But my interest in photography was awakened by that point. And back in the late 60s, I joined a photo club at the school where I was going at, and I bought my first 35mm camera, and I went from there. Went in the Army, joined the Army, and was in the photo lab most of the time. I was not in the photo workers, but I did it on the side. After I got out of the Army, I went to Los Angeles Trade Technical School for a two-year program on photography, and I got a certificate from there in photography. I worked part-time in a photo studio for a while, doing wedding photography, and it's just something that it's an art form that I can do. My entire family, my father, my brothers and sisters, they're all artists. They can paint, they can draw, they can see things and translate it down to paper. I can see things, but I cannot draw. But I can use a camera to make or catch an image. And that's where it is. My favorite kind of photography is portrait photography. Different kinds of portraits. You can make people pretty happy when you give them a nice photo of themselves. I totally believe in available light photography or little technical stuff to make the photograph that you need. I've used a run of photo studio with four lights and with all this stuff, and it's, you bring it in, you set up the background, you photograph 100 some people. But that's all gone, that's over. When they went to digital, I got rid of all my film cameras and I use either my iPhone or a little Canon camera for most of my work. And again, I teach the class, making photos is in your eye and in your brain, and the thing that you use is just a tool, and it doesn't matter what kind of brand it is, what kind of size it is, if it can make a picture or if it can capture an image, use it and go for it.
I have no particular background in photography. I traveled a lot and I just took snapshots, but about 15 years or so ago, I thought, well, this isn't, I see so many beautiful things and I should really do a much better job. So I got myself a Nikon film camera at that time because digital was still, well, 3 pixels. And luckily I had a friend who was a cinematographer and he helped me a lot. And then I really started, when I traveled, I really started to pay good attention to taking good photos, good compositions, the best I could do. And I've been the president of the club for several times, and I'm so glad we have Ben now, who's been such a great teacher, and he makes it so interesting, and he gives us homework to do, which is great. It gives you the incentive to go out and look for things, and with everything I do, I learn a lot of times, most of the time, I learn from my mistakes rather than the good things I do. And I learn from other photos that other people take. So I've really paid a lot more attention also to other people's photography, because now I know more about it and I know more what I should be looking for.
Can you tell us about when you meet and where you meet?
Yes, we do meet in Clubhouse 3 in room 9 every second Thursday of the month at 1:30 p.m. And we always bring in photos that we had taken, up to 3 photos in a 16x20 mat. And then we choose the 3 winners, which will then publicize in the Leisure World newspaper.
Are you accepting new members at this time, or are you closed?
Anytime. We're open to the public, and everyone is welcome.
And how would they get in touch with you?
I have my phone number on the cork board in Clubhouse 3.
And what is that number?
It's 562-430-7978.
Okay. Anything else?
Yes, I would like to make a comment that for the last couple of years, the Photo Arts Club has had their photos on display in Clubhouse 3. Okay? And also in the medical center, when you're going down the hall towards the physical therapy department, there's also a display of photographs. So if you haven't seen them, make an effort to come out and look at the pictures. We change them once a month, and they're wonderful pictures. You'll enjoy them.
Any other comments?
Like the applause sign.
Thank you. Today we have 2 members of the Photo Arts Club. And they're going to talk about the pictures they have submitted for a contest today, right? And you're going to talk to us about your composition and all that good stuff about the clubs, the photos. Okay, can you introduce yourself and tell us about your photograph?
My name is Edward Larry Beggs, B-E-G-G-S. I'm primarily a writer, but in junior college I took a course in photography with darkroom developing, and that was exciting. And then I've been interested in it ever since. But I started out with an inexpensive Tower box camera from Sears Roebuck for maybe $2. But I got into a twin lens reflex, which took excellent photographs. And I took this photograph with a twin lens reflex 50 years ago. And this is ektachrome that still has its vibrant colors, Kodak ektachrome. And this is gonna be the cover of a book a children's book I've been writing for 20 years. And it's going to be published by Kindle Publishing soon. This is the cover photo of it. And this is my son, he's 50 now, and his dog, an elk hound. And this is Lake Chelan. And in the 25 pictures I took to make this children's book, that the unifying theme of that was this red hat in every picture, kind of carried it through. And it's about a grandmother teaching her grandson, 5, the grandmother's 80, teaching him how to work in the garden, things like that. And it's a lovely book. I've been, as I said before, I've been working on it for 20 years. Finally, I think it's going to be published in a few weeks. So I'm primarily a writer, but I've also been interested in photography. So what I do is I'll interview someone, let's say at the Cadillac Hotel in Venice Beach or the Cadillac Hotel in San Francisco, and interview people. But I also like to get their pictures while I'm interviewing them and put those together. It's like photojournalism, really. And so yeah, I found that my camera interest and photography interest just supplements the whole written page most of the time. And in the books I write, I just flood them with images that I like myself. So this is one of my favorite images right here. That's going to be a book cover for Grandma's Summer Wonderland. And so that's my story.
Okay, Mara, do you have something to say about your attempt to bribe the judges?
It didn't work. I'm Mara Williams. Photography was always something that I found very, very interesting. Last night I went through the box of photos I took years ago, and they were horrible, but still the memory was preserved. I joined a video producers club a couple of years ago, and I just absolutely love that club. I learned so much from them, and when I heard about the photo and art shop, club, I said, well, that would be a nice place to go and learn even more about taking pictures. So this was my first attempt to take a portrait with my cell phone. And I chose my mentor, my teacher, Joe Asuda, for a face. I wish I could have done a better job at the picture, but still I'm proud of it. And I guess that's all.
And it just happens that that guy that you photographed is one of the judges, right?
Well, I really kind of expected an honorary mention or something. And you're welcome to have a good one.
Thank you, Mara. You get honorary mention.
Thank you.
Alrighty.
By the way, I submitted this picture today. It's not the right picture to submit to this portraiture thing, because it's not really a portrait, but it is a nice picture. I love it. And I thought I was just going to bring it and compete with the rest of the pictures, but I didn't realize that they were all going to be portraits. So it's kind of a mistake, but a nice mistake, because I got to be here to see the wonderful photographs that people made.
OK, Okay, are there any questions from the audience?
Well, I was attracted to your photograph, but I also didn't consider it to be a portrait.
No, it wasn't.
But, you know, one of my favorite film in the film era was Ektachrome, for the way it rendered blues and grays and the cooler colors in the spectrum. You know, if you did pro photography, you probably chose it for that same reason.
I didn't really intelligently choose it.
Okay.
But I did choose it. And I've noticed that after 50 years, the colors are still firm and bright.